Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData project at Easter Seals Crossroads. And today we're going to be talking about a Chrome extension called Natural Reader. So let's go ahead and take a look.
So today we're going to take a look at something called Natural Reader. I mentioned that earlier. Natural Reader is a great text-to-speech program that's on the computer. What you see in front of you, I've got Wikipedia Simple English. If you're looking for a very simple Wikipedia page, you can actually bring up Simple Wikipedia, which makes things easier to understand, removes a lot of images and other information, just makes it kind of a stripped down version of the full version of Wikipedia. Anyways, we brought up a page of the flag of the United States. And I'm going to look up here. If you follow my mouse cursor up to the top right-hand corner, there's this little N in my toolbar. I'm in Chrome currently. And so I'm going to go ahead and click on this N. I've already installed Natural Reader. You do have to purchase Natural Reader. We purchased the personal version, but it does allow you to be able to install a extension into Chrome to allow you to be able to use it here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to press this N, and you're going to see a little window pop up. It's got a couple of things in here. I've got a little square up in the top hand corner that'll let me drag that menu around, put it anywhere on my screen so I can see what's maybe below it or around it. I've also got this person in here. This is the voice we're using, and I'm going to open it up. Currently, we're using Jane, but I've got a series of different voices depending on what voice I want to hear it in. I can choose that. I've got a play button. We'll get to that in just a moment. I've also got a book up here. We'll talk about that in a moment as well. And we've got these little pincer arrows where you can kind of make it even a smaller version of the menu just to kind of hide some things for you. And so I'm going to go ahead and open it back up, and I'm just going to hit my play button. I'm just out here on the main page. I haven't clicked on anything. I haven't moved around anywhere. And so I'm going to click the play button. And what you're going
to find. The last states to join the United States were Alaska and Hawaii in 1959. Alaska joined on January 3, 1959, so the new flag with 49 stars was used from July 4, 1959. Hawaii joined on August.
I'm going to pause it, and I'm going to go over here and change my voice. I'm going to go back to Davis. He's kind of the default one up here. I'll go ahead and choose that. Notice on the bottom of this voice, when you choose a voice, you can change the speed at which it reads. So if you prefer to have it read a little bit faster or a little bit slower so you can better comprehend what's there, that's also helpful and important. So once I choose the voice, I'll go ahead and hit the X to close that, and I'll just keep hitting play. It'll pick up where it left off.
Hawaii joined on August 21st, 1959, so the flag with 50 stars that is used today was not flown until July 4th, 1960. The colors in the flag are red, white, and blue.
Okay, and I'll go ahead and pause it. One thing I want to show you is this little book. I mentioned this before. If you click on this book, it's going to go ahead and then do some, it'll kind of, notice it stripped out all of the different pictures and images, just brought up the text, and then I can start reading again. I'll bring my cursor up to the top.
Flag of the United States. The flag of the United States of America is a national flag. It has 7 red stripes and 6 white stripes. These 13 stripes represent the original 13 colonies. The flag also has a blue canopy.
Notice there is, when you are reading, you can go backwards.
The flag also has a blue canton. It has 7 red. The flag of the United States of America.
I'll hit my pause. So that's just a really quick overview of Natural Reader. It really is really helpful. You can also, I guess one other thing I'll show you before I leave, but you can go ahead and increase the text size, the spacing, other kinds of things in here, just making that text easier to see. But that's Natural Reader. I hope this was helpful, and you should check it out. It's a pretty useful tool. Thanks.
Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.